everyone, it's that time again, time for our daily sketch challenge of botanicals. We're going to spin the wheel and see what it lands on and give it a go. Just to quickly run through pencil basics, as I haven't done it since the first one. We have B, which stands for the blackness basically of the pencil, and the higher the number it gets softer and darker. And H is hardness, so the higher the number the harder it gets, and in the middle is HB. The best thing to do when you've got a set of pencil is to just do some swatches and get a feel for them, going from light pressure to heavy pressure, and see how they look. So I usually use anything between a 2BB, HB or H, okay, for sketching. So I'm going to pop that away. So far up until now, we have done forget-me-nots, we have done the gerberas, we have the calathea, and hemlock yesterday. So let's see, it's the fifth today. Let's see what our fifth design will be. I'm going to go over to spin the wheel. It will make a noise, it sort of claps when it lands on something. Lilac. Is it going to be lilac? Yes. Okay. So we're going to go over to Pixabay again. I use pixabay.com because it is license free images, and that means we can use them and not get into any trouble over copyright. So now it's showing me all things that are lilac rather than just the lilac plant. So let's see if I put plant in, if it will search for lilac plant only. Let's try it. Hang on. That's better. It's a bit better anyway. Okay, so the lilac that I see as being lilac is this one here and this one here in the vase. Let's do the one in the vase, and we'll do an overall feel of the lilac rather than going into the detail. Remember, this is sketch a day. I try and aim them to be about 10 minutes and no more. Let's get that downloaded so that you have the entire photo on the screen, and then we can get started. Okay. So the pencils you might need, I have mentioned 2B, HB, B is what I have. You might need some shading stumps. You might need a rubber of some kind. I've got a rubber eraser, I've got a kneadable eraser, and I have an electric eraser as well. And sometimes I like to go over my designs with a fine liner pen, so that might be useful for you too. Right, I'm just going to move the keyboard out of the way so it's not on the camera. You don't need to see that. Right, so the best thing to do when you're sketching is to get an overall feel for the layout of what you're looking at, the composition basically. So what I'm going to do is start, for me, I always like to start with the shape of the vase, because once we've got that in, we can then work our way up to the top. And remember, this is only the first pass, so we do it a few times. So I don't think I'm actually going out enough for the vase, so I'm going to come out more. That's more like it, and then it seems to come out again. It goes in and out rather than straight down, so I'm getting there, and that's okay to make those mistakes. Normally I wouldn't rub them out to begin with, but I don't want it to confuse me when I start to do the rough outline of everything else. So I still don't feel that it's right. I think this one isn't going up right, so I'm going to keep going until I feel like I can get that as perfect as I can, for my eyes anyway. Okay, right, so here at the front we've got some lilac in that kind of shape. Then we've got another bunch here, Then we've got a teeny little bunch here that is kind of actually off the vase. And then coming from there, in fact, that's too big. That's too big. So go in, I'm going to make that right. There's a little one right here. And then on the outside of the vase coming in, there's like another little one here. And then there's this big kind of bunch there. There it is, looking at this. So it's all about observation. I've just realised that the top of this one isn't in the right place because it goes higher than that one. And then it needs to go higher again and come down. So remember, this is just the overall outline shapes. And then here, round, can you see that little bunch there? And then there is another bit in here. Right, there's a tiny little bit there. And then we've got a bigger bush of the... See, this is where I went a little bit wrong with the shape. I went a bit too wide. Now we've got this little bit of lilac that's hanging down here and coming out this way. And then it's quite high. It's... Let me think, I've gone too high. It's about there. So remember, as I've said, this is just the first one to guide you where you go in and draw the rest and draw in the detail. So I've got that there, that needs to come. Let me just work it out. That's that one coming up. So this here is kind of, it's like mostly pale there. The pale white is there as well. Just checking these, yeah, still in the same place, that's fine. Pale here, here, and then it comes down to this one here. Struggling to see now where it all is myself. Yes, it's here, because then behind here is this purple one that's coming to here. Go further up to here, there's a little bit popping out there. I mean, at the moment it doesn't look like anything, but that's fine, because you're basically plotting in where everything is from using your observation. Okay, there's a little bit of leaf here, so I'll draw that line in. I know that the sharper lines like that are the leaves, as I'm filling in a minute. So that's a leaf. Come down, and it's like a twisted leaf, like that. And that shows that I haven't come out as far as I should with the actual blossom. So let's get that right. I'm getting there. And I think this should actually come out just a little bit more, a fraction. Okay. I think that might just go up a little too high. Fine. Okay, so over to this side now. And we actually have some leaves popping in to say hello there through the blossoms and coming up and around for this other leaf. They're all kind of twisted, and that's okay. So we've done this first bit, and coming from about here, there's like whiter ones, and then sticking out over here, there is this final big bunch. Now you can see here where I may have made some mistakes. Let's have a look. Nope, that's perfect. It matches up in line. That's exactly where it needs to be. But the leaves are not. So let's just go back and make them much bigger than they are. So I underestimated how big they are because they're almost coming out like this. Pressing too hard, so that's a reminder as well, you know, you've got to be careful of how much you're pressing down. And then there's another one like this, and that's pointing out. And then there's another one that comes in slightly, and there's another one peeping out. But then it's all about the flowers there in that patch. Okay, so as this is a daily sketch, we don't have to worry about every single little blossom because it's just way too much to take on board. But what we can do is a bit of a pattern. So what I do to make flowers look like flowers is I just work around like that. It's just like a wiggly pattern, can you see? So I'm just, okay, just loosely wiggling my pencil about, taking it for a bit of a walk, and that straight away will give the impression of blossom. You'll see in a minute. Now, I'm not worrying too much with what's inside the vase at this moment in time. I want to get what's outside of the vase right first. There's a little leaf dangling down from about here. About here, yeah. Like that. So I just want to draw that in so I don't forget it. Because sometimes you do notice things as you go back to different areas where there are leaves that you haven't quite drawn in all of them. Yeah, so I'm going around. There's another one up here. There we go. Okay. So I can actually see some of the stalk of that one as well. It's kind of like that. If you can draw some of the stalks in, or stems, whatever you want to call them, that's a good also... It gives you a good idea of where everything is. Now, the ones I really want to focus on and make sure they do actually look like four-petaled flowers, because they are four-petaled on here, but they're actually quite face-on, is these ones here that make up the white ones that make up this space, because they actually, you can see them quite clearly. So I'm going to do some that are quite clear, just for that section. Now they do become more spaced out, so this area here has leaves behind it, so we're just going to space them out a bit more. Make sure you're spacing them out all over the place as well. Here you can't see them as much, so I'm going to do that wiggly little pattern that I did. Okay, and that then gives the impression of lots of flowers, see, straight away. But there is kind of a space here, there's again some more over here that are all over the place, and we'll draw some of those in, but I want to leave that gap behind. I'm going to draw some more in here that are visible. Keep looking back is the best advice I can give you. Just keep looking back, and the photo, the reference photo, will guide you. Let's have a look. So there is a leaf kind of popping through there. Now this really is just now lots of petals making the lilac stand out. So where it's darker, what I'll do is I will turn that black and white for us. So now you can see where they are lighter. So the bit in the middle that I was talking about needs to be the lightest, and that's why I've spaced them all about. Then this bit here needs to be more mid-range. So what you do, you can either press a little bit harder or stack those little wiggles that you're painting a bit closer together. OK, Okay. And because I have outlined those ones that are not so dark quite heavily, I'm now going to pull that back with the kneadable eraser. So we've marked in, we know where we want them to be, and now we can fade them out and make them paler again. And that means we can see that leaf fair, and I can see that we need a few more. But now I'm going to just press, because I've got most of that in, I'll press really lightly just to finish off that section really lightly. Okay. Right, so this part here hanging over, that's slightly darker than that middle one, but not massively. So we'll go in and try and make it so that all the wiggles are really close together, press a bit harder, and it will make it a little bit darker. It's all about the value, so you get your value from black to white and all the greys in between. When you're sketching and you're only using black and white, you have to think about that quite a lot. So I'm throwing in a bit dark around here because I can see on the black image at the bottom, there's like a bit of shadow in here. Right, so now I'm moving on to here again. It's still just that mid-range grey. Don't want to go crazy. And it's really important to get some bits in there that are dark, and that shows within that part of the plant where the lilac is, there is value, there are changes in value. It won't be just one value in that one section. Like here, there is a little bit that actually is darker than the rest. Okay, and then it starts to look more realistic. So now I'm going out on this side bit, and it's very light on top, so I'm going to hardly press. Draw my little petals in, my little wiggles, and then there's a really dark bit that kind of, it's here, and that leads us down to here, brings the eye down, so the darker parts will want you to look at those bits. There's another bit right on the end. So, and in between, there's variations. So if you start off light, you can then go in and do the variations of the grey and the variations of the darkest, blackest shading. You can almost just do the whole thing in one level of shade, and then you can pick up to make it lighter and you can put the dark in afterwards. So we're going in, carrying on with our little squiggly patterns because that's all the eye reads it as, and then I'm going in here where it's darker in places again, just showing the value that there are spaces where the light is hidden, and that's where it's darker, and there are spaces where the light is being hit mostly, which will be on the top. Okay. Now, let's have a look at this bit here and that bit. So it's quite light, this bit here as well, but I can't see any petals, so we'll just do our wiggles. Not like over here, the petals were really clear. Okay, and then now this part here has quite a bit of dark in the bottom, so I'm going to go in and actually do quite a bit of dark straight away. Quite a bit of those dark values. We're getting to the point where there are more underneath because the light is coming from that direction. And so the value, the dark values are really popping out. So, done that. Now I'm just going in, trying to make them look petally, and it really is that change in value, the lights and the darks, that helps to bring it to life, especially when you're doing quick sketching, which is what we are trying to achieve, a very quick sketch. Okay, and now this one, the stem is dark on one side but then light on the other, so let's do it that way. Okay, and again, there's a lot of difference between the values here. I can really see some darkness. It's almost in the from the center. You can definitely see that's where the darkness is, and here again. But it's actually quite dark on top of this one, so I feel as though the light's hitting it slightly from the front. That's why this one that's behind is darker. So we'll go in and fill that in. Okay. Again, doing my petal lookalikey strokes. I'm doing them really light, and then I will go in and do the mid-range now, so that those black ones don't look like they're standing out just on their own. And then I'll come back here and make sure that they are both kind of, because they are even in value, these ones here make them look quite similar. Here is a leaf, so I'm going to shade, I'll flat shade those because there's no pattern on them, and I'm just flat shading where the leaves are curving. Lighter on the top where the light is, and then darker underneath where it's dark. Literally just looking at the leaves and judging how dark they need to be. The ones at the front, I think the light is coming slightly from the front, because the ones at the front seem to be quite light. Okay, so just flat shading those in. And this one here is quite dark, just a little bit sticking out. These ones over here, let's get these done while I'm thinking about leaves. That's dark, dark value. In here is really dark value. And then it's light up here. The leaf curling round, and then light here too. It's a little bit of dark in here. That's light, that's medium, and I'd say that's just medium. There we are. So we've got some leaves sticking out there, and you can start to see everything coming together after a while. This leaf here is really dark, so we'll just go in there. And this is quite a dark section of the lilac. Now, in between where I've done my lighter flowers, it's actually quite dark and you can't see what's behind the flowers. So I'm just going to go in between them a little bit. And that can represent other leaves that are behind there. Okay, right, coming out here, again, it's about being quite dark with this one, because this is, I'd say, one of the darkest value of the lilac stems. Yeah, and the petals of that one are really going to stand out, so going in a bit heavier. I mean, if you wanted to change pencil to get the different values and get the darker bees and stuff, that's fine. I just like to just get your way with one pen. I imagine sort of like if I was doing this okay, sorry about that little stop there. It stopped recording and I had to remove some files because there wasn't quite enough disk space. Right, now I am going in and just putting some looser, lighter feel of petals just around the edges, because that's where the sun is. There we are. Some more here. And this is my style of sketching. The one thing that is so good about artwork is that there are loads of different styles and ways of doing things. There's no one right way. Don't let anyone tell you that. Okay, you do it your way. Pick up a pencil and just get drawing, and that's how you learn. Don't worry about other people's opinions of what you're doing. So I'm going in, I'm doing some lighter ones on this one. This is more of a mid-range one, but it does get quite dark down in the middle and leading into that flower. I'm just going to go round again. Lighter ones here. Always looking. See, I can see some petal shapes, actual petal shapes sticking out there that I'm going to put in. Right. There, oh, missed this bit down here. So down here, there are just a few very light petals, but we can actually see them, so we'll draw those in. And it's quite light round here, but then it gets dark right in here. And that's where it's overshadowed by the one above it. So we'll just draw that in. Again, this is just my way of doing it. Everybody's different, and some of us, like me, were self-taught, so I've learnt by doing a variety of courses online, and all of the tutors did things differently, and that's okay. So I'm coming in amongst the lighter petals here and just putting a bit more variation in here. There's more of a medium grey shade of petals. I think we are pretty much there. There does seem to be a bit more leaf sticking out here. Let's get that in. Gives it a bit more interest. Okay, so what I'm going to do again is just really lighten that area there. Just putting the kneadable eraser down and lifting where the white petals are, because they really are much lighter than everywhere else, and even on those leaves, they are quite pale leaves because the light's hitting them. Is there anywhere else I need to lift? Maybe a little bit down here, but I'd say apart from the vase, that is done. And to be honest, I'm not too worried about doing anything with the vase. It could just be a plain coloured vase, so I'm just going to put some more details in, just carefully draw in a few lines just to show that it's 3D, coming in around the shape that it is, just shading it in lightly. It actually is quite dark under there where the leaves are, so I'll go over that, but I'm doing it lightly so as not to make a mistake. It's really dark there. And then it becomes much lighter at the bottom. You can see where the light's coming from because it's all light on this side. And then it gets much darker over there. Now, because we've shaded the whole of that bottom section, we can bring the stumps into play. Now, my cats have chewed mine, but they still do the job, so it's fine. And you'll see that they, if you have done some flat shading like that, it really does just nicely smooth it out and show where the lights and darks are. As I said, I'm not going to go into the detail of the leaves inside. We'll just pretend that it's, leave it there. So today's was, I always use my liner pen for this. I name it every day. We had the lovely lilac. I used to have a lilac tree in the back of my garden and I absolutely loved it, but it used to grow so much every year and we were constantly cutting it back, but I've moved since, don't have it anymore. So then I would put July 5th, 2022 botanical challenge, And that way you can put them in a scrapbook. If you don't want to use them, I mean, you could use them, you could add some colour with pencils, watercolour, I say this every time. You could actually use it in a scrapbook. You could use it to send in a card. You could finish off the detail of the vase if you wanted to. It could be a mini picture and you could frame it. So there's all sorts of things you can do, but I shall be adding it to my scrapbook of the whole 31 days of July. Okay, it's been really lovely and I've enjoyed that one today, a bit more tricky. Hope you enjoyed it too and I'll see you tomorrow. Oh, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already and click that notification bell. You can tell I'm new to this, I keep forgetting.